Hello, my name is Zeke Robison, and this is Tech in 2, the coronavirus update from Wired.
Brought to you by American Express Business. American Express offers a line of cards to help take your business further, because with needs like yours, you need a card designed for business.
Ranked choice voting may be coming to your next election. Ranked choice is when voters can rank which candidates they prefer first, second, or third. The winner then gets calculated through successive tallies. It's a departure from the winner-take-all system most U.S. districts are used to. New York City is trying it in its mayoral race. It's supposed to chill out negativity and aggression in campaigns because candidates might want to avoid alienating another candidate's diehard stands. And it might even open up elections to a wider range of ideologies, giving third-party candidates a window of opportunity as everyone's third choice. But some argue that a more complicated ballot might make it harder for people with less education or language skills to understand the instructions to vote. If New York City's mayoral election goes well, ranked choice voting may be the way you cast your next ballot, too. Next, an observatory is spying on LA's carbon emissions from space, and its data could be used to impact climate change policy across the globe. It's not hard to believe, but Los Angeles produces the fifth most CO2 of all the cities on the planet. That fact makes it a perfect spot for studying the role humans play in climate change. And it's one area where scientists are using an instrument that reads sunlight intensity to determine carbon dioxide in Earth's atmosphere. The instrument is called the OCO3, and it launched a few years ago and is now mounted on the International Space Station. It's an improvement over its still-active predecessor, which is locked in a sun-synchronous orbit that passes over LA at the same time every day, meaning it can only check the city's atmospheric CO2 levels at 1:30 in the afternoon. Scientists are now looking at combining the strengths of space-based monitoring with other efforts. The goal isn't to replace other methods of carbon dioxide monitoring, but rather to figure out how to use them together to inform climate change policy across the globe. And on Wired.com, read the story of Jeffrey Fang, who thought he could outfox the gig economy. He was a ride-hailing legend, a top earner with relentless hustle. Then his minivan was carjacked with his kids in the back seat. He'll explain that bringing his kids along on a Saturday night shift made sense until it didn't, and that in hindsight, he understands that it really, really didn't. Read more about it on Wired.com. Want more news you can use? Sign up for the Tech in 2 newsletter at wired.com/TT.
So if you ask anyone in the Wired newsroom what's on your mind, here's what some of us are thinking about.
Big tech.
The coronavirus pandemic.
Climate change.
Disinformation and election security.
What policing should look like in the future.
This is Get Wired. And I'm your host, Lauren Good.
Every story about technology is really a story about people.
The good, the bad, and the ugly.
Get Wired. Subscribe on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Meet Shannon Simmons, owner of Rad Ads Ad Agency. Shannon's biggest client is across the country, and they requested an in-person meeting tomorrow. So she used her American Express Business Cards app feature, which lets her track her business expenses from the last-minute flight to the late-night burrito upon arrival. Big meeting Tuesday, expenses recorded Wednesday, crushing it every day. Built for business by American Express. Don't do business without it. This story features a fictional character from a fictional business. Terms apply. Learn more at americanexpress.com/businesscards.